Alright, Shalawam Yasharala, back again with another Lord with an edifying video. Through the spirit and the power of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah. Alright, before I go any further, I want to give all honor and glory and praises to our Heavenly Father and to His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Rachakodash. And next up, double honors to our apostles and our elders of Great Millstone, who still guard her to the highways and byways and feed us with the 100% truth according to the Bible and Ruel. In peace, blessings, and safety and mercy unto the Akims out there who is pushing the truth in the four corners of the earth with boldness, righteousness, and in sincerity to the best of their abilities. In the names of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushah, Bahashem, Rachakodash, what are people here or what do they forbear? You know, back at it with another lesson through the spirit, Paviyah, Bahashim, Yahushah, Bahashim, Rachakodash. Name of this lesson is going to be called, What's Love According to the Bible, man? You know? So without further ado, we're going to jump right into the scriptures and prove what love is. Because everybody's saying that they love the Lord, you know, but they don't know what love is according to the Bible. So without further ado, let's prove it. This is the book of 1 John 5 and 3. For this is the love of the Most High, that we keep His commandments, and His commandments are not grievous. Exactly, man. So that's love according to the scriptures, man. Keeping the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Bible to the best of your abilities, man. Being a doer of the word and not a hearer only, man. You know? Showing your faith by your works. You know? That's showing Yahabashim Yahushah that you love Him, man. The talent that He gave you. You're not being lazy and not being productive. You're being productive and doing what He tells you to do to the best of your abilities, man. That's showing Yahabashim Yahushah that you fear Him. And that's showing Yahabashim Yahushah that you love Him. So it's like killing two birds with one stone. So this is the book of 1 John 5 and 3 again. For this is the love of Yahabashim Yahushah, who the world eagerly calls God in Jesus Christ. That we keep His commandments, and His commandments are not grievous. Exactly, man. And who were the commandments, the law, statutes, and commandments was given to? You Hebrew Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native American Indians ain't confusing the faces. As a matter of fact, since I mentioned that, you know, and through the spirit of power of Yahabashim Yahushah, I can prove it. So we're going to prove it according to the scriptures. This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 26, verse 46. And it reads, these are the statutes and judgments and laws which Yahweh, Bahashem Yahushah, made between Him and the children of Israel, once again, and the laws which Yahweh, Bahashem Yahushah, made between Him and the children of Israel, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native American Indians, ain't confusing their faces, in Mount Sinai, by the hand of Moses. Exactly. So the only people that received the law, statutes, and commandments of the Bible was the Israelites, which consisted of the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native American Indians. So only the Israelites could love Yahabashim Yahushah, because love is keeping the commandments of the Lord, man, which was only given to the Israelites. So now we're going to go back. Now we're going to go into the book of John 14 and 15. This is Lord Yahushah speaking, who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. And it reads, this is for St. John 14 and 15. If ye love me, keep my commandments. Exactly, man. If you love Yahabashim Yahushah, who the world ignorantly calls God in Jesus Christ, then keep the commandments, man. And like 1 John 5 and 3 said, and His commandments are not grievous, man. It's not hard to keep the law, statutes, and commandments of the Bible, the ones that you can keep anyway, to the best of your abilities, you know. It's not hard to not sleep with the next man's woman. It's not hard to not steal from your brother. It's not hard to stop getting lineups, stop getting tattoos, you know, and so on and so forth, man. You know, keeping the Sabbath, that's not hard. Keeping the high holy days, that's not hard, you know. The law, statutes, and commandments that we can keep, we try to keep to the best of our abilities, man. You know, out of the fear of Yahabashim Yahushah. And that shows that we also love the Lord, man. Because love is an action word, not an expression. You know? It's more of an action. It's more of a verb than an expression. You know? So now we're going to go to the book of John, chapter 21, verse 15. This is the book of St. John 21 and 15. And it reads, So when they had dined, Yahushua saith to Simon Peter, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me more than these? And he saith unto him, Yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. And he saith unto him, Feed my lambs. Exactly, man. You know, this is what Lord Yahushua was telling Peter, the head apostle Peter, what he needs to do, man. You know, and that's metaphoric for doing the work. That's what the Lord Yahushua was saying. It wasn't talking about actually feeding literal lambs. It was talking about feeding the people, man, the Israelites. So-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native American Indians by preaching the gospel, which means good news. Preaching the words to them, you know, whether they will hear, whether they forbear. You know, verse 16, he saith unto him again the second time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? And he saith unto him, Yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. He saith unto him, Feed my sheep. Verse 17, and he saith unto him the third time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me?
I can search the web for that.
Oh, Slakia, wow. where'd that come from? Slakia. St. John 21 and 17, he saith unto him the third time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? Peter was grieved because he saith unto him the third time, Lovest thou me? And he saith unto him, Lord, thou knowest all things. Thou knowest that I love thee. Yahushua saith unto him, Feed my sheep. Exactly. So that proves the importance of doing the work. That proves the importance of loving Yahushua, which is doing the work, man. You know? Because Lord Yahushua told Peter, the head apostle Peter, that times. So he was like, feed my lambs, feed my sheep, feed my sheep, pretty much do the work, then do the work, then do the work, then do the work. You know what I'm saying? That means it's very important, man. You know? And the work that we're doing, starting off with our apostles and our elders of great millstone, the works that we're doing through the spirit of Yahushua is very important. You know? So now we're going to go to the book of 2 John, verse 6. And it reads, this is love, that we walk after his commandments. This is the commandment that as ye have heard from the beginning, ye shall walk in it. Exactly, man. Being doers of the word, man. And this was something that was instilled in us from the beginning, man. You know, keeping the law, statutes, and commandments of the scriptures. Whether they was orally, like in the book of Genesis, until the physically, they was written down. You know what I'm saying? And giving it to Moses in the book of Exodus, man. You know? But even in Genesis and Exodus, man, and even until now, in 2019, the year of Karagma, the law, statutes, and commandments of the Bible, we have to keep to the best of our abilities if we want to show Yahushua, who the world ignorantly calls God and Jesus Christ, that we love them, man, and fear them, you know? And want to do his work to the best of our abilities, man. Starting off with our apostles and our elders of Great Millstone, down to younger brothers like us that's doing this work in sincerity and in truth in the names of Yahushua. You know? So anyway, that was it through the spirit of Yahushua. You know, I pray that this lesson was edifying through the spirit of Yahushua. Before I close out, I want to say, Kol Haloyim Hala Yahweh Bahashem Yahushua Bahashem Rachakwadash. Next up, double honors to our apostles and our elders of Great Millstone. And peace, blessings, and safety and mercy unto the Yakims out there who is pushing the truth in the four corners of the earth. With that, I want to say Shalom, Wa Kwam Yasharalam.